Good morning.
Good morning.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Lord is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
On this day the Lord has acted, we will rejoice and be glad in it. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. At page 79, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you
in thought, word,
deed,
have done,
by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart, not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry. We humbly repent. Think of your Son, Jesus Christ. Mercy on us.
Forgive us.
And delight in your will,
in your ways,
your ways,
of your name,
your name.
Amen.
Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Page 80, Lord, open our lips,
and our mouths shall praise your
praise.
Glory to the Father,
the Son, the Holy Spirit,
was in the beginning,
was in the beginning,
now will be forever.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The nighty, please.
Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and show ourselves glad in him with songs. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the corners of the earth, and the strength of the hills is his also. Thus he is, and he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. Oh, come, let us worship and fall down, and in the Lord our Savior. For he is the Lord our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand in awe. For he cometh, to judge the earth, and with righteousness to judge the world, and the peoples with his truth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
We continue with Psalm 56 and 57. That is found beginning at page 62 in the Book of Common Prayer. We'll read this responsively, breaking at the asterisk in each verse. The 56th Psalm. Have mercy on me, O God, for my enemies are hounding me.
All day long
they assault and oppress me.
They hound me all the day long.
Truly, there are many who fight against me, O Most High.
Whenever I am afraid,
I will put my trust in you.
In God, whose word I praise, in God I trust and will not be afraid.
For what can flesh do to me?
All day long they damage my cause.
Their only thought is to do me evil.
They band together, they lie in wait.
They spy upon my footsteps,
seek my life. Shall they escape despite their wickedness?
O God, in your anger,
cast down the people.
You have noted my lamentation, put my tears into your bottle.
Are they not recorded in your book?
Whenever I call upon you, my enemies will be put to flight.
This I know, for God is on my side.
God, the Lord, whose word I praise, in God I trust and will not be afraid.
For
what can mortals do to me?
I am bound by the vow I made to you, O God.
I will present you
thank offerings.
For you have rescued my soul from death and my feet from stumbling.
I may walk before God in the light of the living.
Be merciful to me, O God, be merciful, for I have taken refuge in you.
In the shadow
of your wings will I take refuge until this time of trouble has gone by.
I will call upon the Most High God.
The God who maintains my cause.
He will send from heaven and save me. He will confound those who trample upon me.
God will send forth his love and his faithfulness.
I lie in the midst of lions that devour the people.
Their teeth, they come with sharp swords.
They have laid a net for my feet, and I am bowed low.
They have dug a pit for me, but
have fallen into it themselves.
Exalt yourself above the heavens, O God.
And your glory over all the earth.
My heart is firmly fixed, O God, my heart is fixed.
I will sing and make melody.
Wake up my spirit, awake lute and harp.
I must awaken the dawn.
I will confess you among the peoples, O Lord.
I will sing praise to you among the nations.
Your loving kindness is greater than the heavens.
And your faithfulness reaches to the clouds.
Exalt yourself above the heavens, O God.
And your glory over all the earth.
Glory to the Father, and
to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was
in the beginning,
and will be forever.
Amen. I invite you to mute until after the Apostles' Creed now, and we'll have Jenny read.
A reading from Leviticus 16, 1 through 19. The Lord spoke to Moses after the death of the two sons of Aaron, when they drew near before the Lord and died. The Lord said to Moses, tell your brother Aaron not to come just at any time into the sanctuary inside the curtain before the mercy seat that is upon the ark, or he will die, for I appear in the cloud upon the mercy seat. Thus Aaron, come into the holy place with a young bull for a sin offering and a ram for a burnt offering. He shall put on the holy linen tunic and shall have the linen undergarments next to his body, fasten the linen sash, and wear the linen turban. These are the holy vestments. He shall bathe his body in water and then put them on. He shall take from the congregation of the people of Israel two male goats for a sin offering and one ram for a burnt offering. Aaron shall offer the bull as a sin offering for himself and shall make atonement for himself and for his house. He shall take two goats and set them before the Lord at the entrance of the tent of meeting. And Aaron shall cast lots on the two goats, one lot for the Lord and the other lot for Azazel. Aaron shall present the goat on which the lot fell for the Lord and offer it as a sin offering. But the goat on which the lot fell for Azazel shall be presented alive before the Lord to make atonement over it, so that it may be sent away into the wilderness to Azazel. Aaron shall present the bull as a sin offering for himself and shall make atonement for himself and for his house. He shall slaughter the bull as a sin offering for himself. He shall take a censer full of coals of fire from the altar before the Lord and two handfuls of crushed sweet incense. And he shall bring it inside the curtain and put the incense on the fire before the Lord
so that the cloud of the incense may cover the mercy seat that is upon the covenant, or he will die. He shall take some of the blood of the bull and sprinkle it with his finger on the front of the mercy seat, and before the mercy seat he shall sprinkle the blood with his finger seven times. He shall slaughter the goat of the sin offering that is for the people, and bring its blood inside the curtain, and do with its blood as he did with the blood of the bull, sprinkling it upon the mercy seat and before the mercy seat. Thus he shall make atonement for the sanctuary because of the uncleannesses of the people of Israel and because of their transgressions, all their sins, so that he shall do for the tent of meeting, which remains with them in the midst of their uncleannesses. For no one shall be in the tent of meeting from the time he enters to make atonement in the sanctuary until he comes out and has made atonement for himself and for his house and for all the assembly of Israel. Then he shall go out to the altar that is before the Lord and make atonement on its behalf, and shall take some of the blood of the bull and of the blood of the goat and put on each of the horns of the altar. He shall sprinkle some of the blood on it with his finger seven times and cleanse it and hallow it from the uncleannesses of the people of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from Matthew, chapter 6, verses 1 through 6 and 16 through 18. Beware of practicing your piety before others in order to be seen by them, for then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners so that they may be seen by others. Truly I tell you, they have received the reward, but when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And when you fast, do not look dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces so as to show others that they are fasting. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not before others, but by your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We'll continue with the Apostles' Creed. It's found at page 96, after which you are free to unmute. With saints around the globe and across the centuries, let us affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Continue with the prayers at page 97. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
And
recognize
the kingdom, power, and glory
forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Your peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
You are saving hope among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
For the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
We continue with our prayers, praying for our parish in a time of transition. Almighty God, you know the needs of your church in every place. Look graciously upon the people of St. James and grant us the guidance of your Spirit as we move through the search process for a new rector. Thank you for faithful stewards you have provided and will provide for our leadership. Give us discernment, wisdom, patience, and confidence in your timing. Bless those who've agreed to serve on the search committee. We give thanks for them. Bless our new rector, whoever and wherever he or she may be. Help us to care for each other in this time with mutual trust, respect, kindness, and clarity of purpose. You are the good shepherd, and we ask you to shepherd us throughout this journey. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We pray for our church and the world in this time and health crisis. We pray for the church that it may not grow weary of proclaiming the gospel of Christ and serve as beacon of hope to a suffering world. We pray for Michael, our presiding bishop, for Rob, our bishop, for our interim rector, Pierce, our clergy, staff, vestry, wardens, and all who minister in your name. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all affected by the virus around the world, for the leaders of nations, that they may work together for the common good as the outbreak spreads. Grant public health and government officials in our nation the strength and will to act swiftly and decisively with wisdom and compassion in service to all. We pray for our president and for his staff, and especially those who are suffering with the virus. For the Congress and governors and mayors and all elected officials. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heal those who are sick with the virus. May they have access to medical care and regain their strength and health. Grant them your healing grace and give strength to all who care for them. We pray for healthcare workers with thanksgiving for this ministry who, with hearts of service, stand on the front lines of providing care. Grant them courage and protection as they put the needs of public safety before their own. Bless scientists and researchers around the world as they combat the virus, that their work may yield knowledge to develop a vaccine, treatments, and improve measures to reduce its spread. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the safety and well-being of all who travel and those who remain quarantined. Remove the presence of fear and anxiety from our hearts, that confident in your providence, we may be generous in sharing resources. Grant that our churches and communities of faith may reflect your love as they minister to the most vulnerable among us. Fill them with your Holy Spirit as they work to be your healing hands and feet to all in need. Lord, mercy.
Our
prayer.
We pray for those who have already lost loved ones to the virus and those who will yet suffer such loss, that they may know the consolation of your love. We pray for all who have died in the hope of the resurrection and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy. Sustain and support the anxious. Be with those who care for the sick and lift up all who are brought low, that we may find comfort knowing that nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And we offer the prayers that are on our hearts, the needs for healing known to us, praying this week for Adrian Jackson, Bill Hale, Ede and Booty Baldridge, Amy McComb, Max, Beth, John, Terry, Tim, Joe, Fred, for Bo Butler, Patrick Romer and his family, and for others who we mention at this time, invite you to say them aloud or to write them in the column on the right. For Jennifer, Hunter Cluis, for Scott and his wife, for Michael, for Kel and Nina, for Wright and Eileen, for Aunt Jen, for Kendall and his grandfather, for Tipper, for Rick, are there any Thanksgivings on your heart this morning? Thanksgiving for Sheila. Happy birthday. Is it Sheila's birthday?
Yes, it is.
Happy birthday, Sheila.
Happy birthday.
The feast of Charity. Awesome.
I wanted to say, Jay, that was a wonderful sermon. And to Cheryl and Pierce,
yeah.
I'm very thankful for you all looking out for us so well. And it's just been wonderful to have these sermons and resources.
Thank you. We give thanks for our mothers. We give thanks for beautiful weather. Give thanks for a 50th anniversary of Dave and Betty, right? I got right. That. I got that right.
Got that right.
Slightly more low-key celebration than might have been originally intended. We give thanks for our first virtual coffee hour yesterday.
Yes, yes, that was fun.
Got to start somewhere, right?
Let us give thanks for the ministry of our vestry, which meets tonight.
For the pink flamingos in my yard.
You got flocked.
Somebody was very stealth.
Well, I'm glad you got flamingos. I once had a big birthday and I got dinosaurs.
Thanks for a successful end of semester at UNCW.
It is wonderful.
I want to give thanks for friends that sit outside and watch music and that just enjoy the part of life that we can enjoy and be thankful.
I give thanks that Brooklyn is represented in our gathering this morning.
Pierce, can I be thankful for Rob too, because he started me on a journey in Newfoundland now, and I've been reading books and reading about the generosity of people that I didn't even know about. Yeah. So in the midst of horror, people were really, really good. And I think that's happening now as well. Thank you, Rob.
Pierce, would you read the general Thanksgiving, please?
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love for the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, the honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen.
Amen.
Holy and sovereign Lord, when the earth and all its people quake, you hold its pillars firm. What is uncertain and frightening to us is completely known to you and controlled by you. Look mercifully on the people of St. James Parish and other congregations near to our heart. Although at this time we're apart from each other, we pray your Holy Spirit to unite us as one. Pour upon us your peace, which passes all understanding. Keep us safe and healthy. And above all, keep us mindful of those to whom we should show the love and compassion of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to
God. Alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
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 Good one.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Everybody have a good day.
Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Amen.